When running remote unmoderated studies, we risk having participants who are not motivated to actually try the tasks. They just want to get their incentive money as quickly as possible. This can be a particularly big problem if you're recruiting from a panel, but it can happen even if you do your own recruiting and you bring your own participants. It's important to identify these people and to make sure that you exclude their data from your analysis. We can think about two types of problem participants you might want to catch: cheaters and outliers. A cheater is a participant who's just trying to get their incentive money and move on. Often these people don't even try the tasks at all. In UX research, an outlier is a participant whose behavior or performance is very different from the rest of your user population. But just because a participant is an outlier does not necessarily mean that they're also a cheater. They might just not really be representative of your user group, so maybe they shouldn't have been recruited in the first place. So how do we catch these people? The best way to do this is to watch all of the video recordings from the study. If you're running a qualitative study, you should be doing that anyway for your analysis. It isn't too hard to watch 5 20-minute videos. You should be able to notice when a participant isn't trying the tasks. Sometimes you'll even see people open the task instructions, go read Facebook or their email for a few minutes, and then click done to end the task. When a person is an outlier and not a cheater, they might be a bit harder to identify. Listen to what they say in their video. If you meant to recruit people with a background in industrial engineering, for example, and one participant seems very confused and unfamiliar with the topic, that tells you that maybe this is a person who shouldn't have been recruited in the first place. Look back at how that person ended up in the study as a participant and double check your screener. If you ran a quantitative study, you may have tested anywhere from 20 to 50 participants, and you may not have time to watch all of the recordings. But maybe you can just watch 5 minutes in the middle of each video to spot check. But another quick way to find outliers is to check the quantitative data. Most quantitative usability studies involve collecting time on task and task success. With time on task, we can look at the distribution of times and see if there's anything that doesn't fit within the larger pattern of data. For example, let's look at this histogram of task times. The majority of participants took between 10 seconds and 178 seconds, but we have 2 participants who were much faster and 4 participants who were much slower. Those people are certainly outliers for this task, but that doesn't necessarily mean that I should go ahead and throw away their data. It does mean that I should investigate further. After identifying those outliers, I might next go and watch the video recordings for those 4 participants to see what's actually going on. Are they actually trying? Are they actually representative of my user group? I can also go and look at task success per participant. So, how many tasks did each participant successfully complete? Maybe one of these participants has a really low task time and is failing most of the tasks. That's a good indication that this person is definitely an outlier and might be a cheater. As you're looking for these cheaters and outliers, make sure you're looking at multiple sources of data to help you decide whether or not they should be removed from your study. If you do find a cheater, check with your unmoderated platform. Many allow you to report problematic participants and they'll offer you a free replacement. And if you find many outliers and cheaters, consider changing how you recruit your users. Keep those problematic participants from getting in your study in the first place.